The A-10 Warthog isn't just an aircraft. It's an airborne tank, a masterclass in durability and firepower. Other aircraft may boast a more streamlined appearance and possess greater engine thrust. There are fighters that don't encounter the same challenges with energy management that the A-10 Warthog faces. However, those planes are equipped with advanced technology and sophisticated computers, not to mention radar systems, which the Warthog regrettably lacks. Nonetheless, despite its shortcomings, the Warthog is remarkable, and its pilots, some of whom affectionately refer to themselves as drivers, hold a deep affection for this flying gun truck. The A-10 was built for one dominant mission, to offer unmatched close air support to troops on the ground.
They're about to do a gun run, you need to get down. Let's go, buddy.
Executing close air support missions is exceptionally challenging due to the complexity of operations, the constant variability of factors on the battlefield, and the critical consequences of any missteps. However, the flight attributes of the A-10 contribute positively to these tasks. Its stability and agility, along with its forgiving nature, make it feel like a dependable ally in achieving the objectives of the mission. Climbing the ladder and settling into the A-10's armored bathtub is a visceral experience. It's snug, functional, no wasted space. Switches and dials greet you, less computerized than modern fighters. You strap in, feeling the reassuring solidity of the titanium armor around you. Being a flying tank, the A-10 Warthog can take a beating like no other aircraft can. The A-10's survivability is central to its design, ensuring it can endure and operate even under intense enemy fire. Armor constitutes nearly 6% of the A-10's empty weight. Its cockpit and parts of its flight control system are protected by 1,200 pounds of titanium armor, aptly termed the bathtub. This armor can withstand direct hits from armor-piercing and high-explosive projectiles up to 23 millimeters. Combined with its redundant systems, these features enable the A-10 to survive conditions that would incapacitate most other aircraft, rendering it a formidable presence in any combat scenario. Firing up the twin General Electric TF-34GE100 turbofan engines is a full body rumble. The whole plane vibrates with barely restrained power. You check instruments, communicate with ground control, and feel the anticipation build as you await clearance for taxiing. But there is a small problem. See, the good old hog doesn't have a parking brake. So the pilot sits on the ground with engines running, no chocks under the wheels, holding down the brakes to keep from rolling for dozens of minutes or more. It's a bit exhausting. But then you push the throttles up, check the gauges one more time at full throttle, then release the brakes. If you've ever been in a fighter jet on takeoff, well, it's not like that. If you've ever been in an old truck when you stomp on the gas, an A-10 taking off is more like that. The A-10 isn't a graceful bird. It lumbers into the air, demanding effort to lift its heavily armored frame. But once airborne, a surprising nimbleness emerges for such a large aircraft. Even with those big Hershey bar wings, it has a very good roll rate. It can turn on remarkably well. With its expansive wing area, high wing aspect ratio, and large ailerons, the A-10 excels at agility at low speeds and altitudes. Its wing configuration aids in brief takeoffs and landings, enabling it to operate from rudimentary forward airfields close to battle lines. Capable of loitering for extended periods and functioning under 1,000-foot ceilings with 1.5-mile visibility, it predominantly cruises at a measured speed of 300 knots. This pace makes it especially suited for ground attack roles compared to faster fighter bombers, which can find it challenging to target small, slow-moving entities. Pilots become familiar with the boundaries of the aircraft's performance capabilities, learning to operate at the brink of maximum efficiency without exceeding it. In addition to being insanely maneuverable, Hog is an incredibly stable and accurate weapons delivery platform. Remember, this is an aircraft designed to destroy enemy armor columns. To achieve this task, it has a distinctive design approach. The entire structure is crafted around the GAU-8 Avenger autocannon, arguably the most powerful autocannon ever integrated into an aircraft. The relationship is so intertwined that without the gun, the aircraft has to be propped up to avoid tipping backwards. Engineers masterfully coupled the A-10 with the GAU-8 Avenger, crafting a union that elevated the A-10 to legendary status among aviation icons. However, integrating the GAU-8 into the A-10 was no small task. With the gun making up 16% of the Warthog's weight, the aircraft's balance was a significant concern. The gun's recoil mirrored the thrust of one of the Warthog's engines, making its alignment crucial. A misaligned gun could send the aircraft veering off course upon firing. Exhaust gases and the gun's powerful muzzle flash presented additional challenges. The flash risked blinding the pilot temporarily, while the oxygen-deprived exhaust gases could extinguish the engines. To combat these issues, engineers incorporated windscreen washers for soot removal and automatic engine igniters to reignite any snuffed-out engines. To grasp the GAU-8's size, visualize it next to a Chevrolet sedan. Excluding other components, the gun stretches 9.35 feet, and with the ammunition feed system, a whopping 19.7 feet. Each barrel extends 7.55 feet. And for weight, when devoid of ammo, it stands at around 619 pounds. When fully packed, the combined weight of the gun and ammunition hovers close to 3,968 pounds. Drawing from the 19th century Gatling gun design, the GAU-8 is an intricate assembly of 7 barrels rotating around its central axis. Instead of the Gatling's hand crank mechanism, the GAU-8 uses 2 hydraulic motors. As the central axis spins, cams guide each barrel through a cyclical process of loading, firing, unloading, and then reloading. What sets the GAU-8 apart is its self-sustaining firing system. Neither the recoil nor the gas from the discharged rounds drive the gun, ensuring that a misfired round doesn't halt subsequent firing. Powering this monumental weapon requires an intricate balance of mechanical and hydraulic energy. The dual hydraulic motors ensure the rapid, seamless rotation of the barrel assembly. This rotation, driven by the aircraft's power systems, facilitates the gun's extraordinary firing rates and ensures the stability of the entire mechanism, even under intense operation. The ammunition employed by the GAU-8 is a tale of engineering genius. Each shell is a 30 by 173mm cannon round, available in three variants. The armor-piercing incendiary variant is cloaked in an aluminum jacket, which protects its formidable core made of depleted uranium. This is complemented by a high-explosive incendiary and a more economically feasible target practice round. The size? Think of a standard Coca-Cola bottle. That's approximately the size of each one of these rounds. Upon initiation, the GAU-8's firepower is evident, dispersing 50 rounds within its first second. It subsequently intensifies to 65 rounds every second, translating up to 4,200 rounds in a minute. Its accuracy doesn't disappoint either. 80% of its shots, when fired from 3,937 feet, fall within a 39.4-foot diameter. With closely matching ballistic performances across ammo types, the PGU-14API armor-piercing round exhibits a muzzle velocity of 3,323 feet per second. This projectile, weighing in at 0.87 pounds, generates an energy output of approximately 203,000 joules. This energy is tenfold that of the acclaimed .50 BMG rounds. No armored vehicle or tank offers adequate protection against this weapon. It slices through armor as effortlessly as a hot knife glides through butter. You scan the terrain, adrenaline spiking when you spot your objective. Analyzing wind conditions, enemy positions, and escape routes becomes second nature. You coordinate the final attack parameters with the troops on the ground or the forward air controller. Strafing runs are where the A-10 becomes the extension of yourself. The words fall short of capturing the profound gut-level experience of being perched atop a 600-pound, 7-barreled Tempest whirling at 3,900 revolutions per minute, unleashing 0.8 pounds of destruction at an astonishing rate of 66 rounds per second. The entire aircraft vibrates as though it might disassemble in flight. Amid the tremors and the cloud of gunpowder shrouding the cockpit, visibility forward becomes impossible. It's not just the sound of the that you hear, it's something you feel throughout your body. Landing a successful strike on a metallic object often results in a spectacular display reminiscent of Independence Day, with the target igniting in a cascade of sparks. Utilizing high explosive incendiary, or HEI, ammunition enhances this effect, ensuring a vivid spectacle with each hit, regardless of the target's nature. But the experience doesn't end there. After disengaging from the target, pilots typically experience forces ranging from 3G to 5G during maneuvering, which in itself is a thrilling sensation. Once stabilized, and if the situation permits a brief respite, pilots might lower their masks to inhale deeply, embracing the distinctive, somewhat bitter yet sweet aroma of gunpowder lingering in the cockpit. In moments when the scent is particularly strong, it might even carry a taste. Returning from a mission, the pilot guides the A-10 back to base, where the process of debriefing begins. This involves reviewing the mission's objectives, outcomes, and any lessons learned. The ground crew immediately begins inspecting and servicing the aircraft to prepare it for its next mission. For the pilot, the completion of a mission brings a mix of relief, satisfaction, and reflection. Flying the A-10 Warthog is not just about piloting an aircraft. It's about being an integral part of a team that supports ground forces, potentially saving lives through precise and effective close air support. There's a unique bond that forms between A-10 pilots and their aircraft, and marvel at its capabilities. This relationship is built on countless hours of training, preparation, and combat missions, where the A-10 and its pilot operate as one. It's a testament to the design and functionality of the A-10, an aircraft built around the needs of close air support and the protection of ground troops in conflict zones. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into flying an A-10 Warthog. There are, of course, many other remarkable aircraft in the US military's inventory. So what do you think about this iconic aircraft? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? And if you were lucky enough to see an A-10 Warthog up close, or better yet, flew one, please comment.
Jeep Hog 1 and 2 are to send down to 15,000 and head back towards our area for the range.
Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.